Hello listeners, welcome to Studio NIOS. I'm Dr. Pooja Chopra. Today we will discuss evolution of Indian society. As you all know that man is a social being. It is immersed in the society since it is born until it dies. But what is society? How it functions? And how societies evolves over a period of time is a question that haunts people since eternity. In this lecture, we will discuss about the concept of society and how Indian society evolves over a period of time. As you all know that society is a web of relationships, and these relations are fundamental for understanding human behavior and different institutions of the society. The term society is rooted in Latin word societas, means friends and ally. The term is used to describe a relation or interaction among groups. Introduction to society. According to American sociologists McClever and Page, society is as a system of usage and procedures of authority and mutual aid, of many groupings and divisions, of control of human behavior and of liberties. Hence, we can see society as a large group of people who interact with each other, share the same culture, territory, and way of life. As you have all heard that another word, community. How community and society are different? Community needs territory, and community is a subsystem of society. And education is a subsystem of community. So all these three terms, society, education, and community, are interrelated and intertwined. The usage of society is very wide and ranges from one small community, village, to world human society, from primitive culture to postmodern cultures, which differs from time and place. However, the concept of community and society are not same. Society is an abstract, broad, and general concept, whereas community is a constituent of society and characterized with definite territory, as we have discussed earlier. Close relationship called we feeling is one of the important characteristics of a community, and cultural similarity is also another characteristics of a community, but not society. Now, coming on the characteristics of a society. First, we will enlist the characteristics of a society. The first characteristics of a society is that members of society are expected to attain values by following prescribed norms, folkways, modes, laws, etc. of society. Norms are the guidelines for behavior. Indian society is characterized by diversity, patriarchy, importance of caste and community. Listeners, you must have heard about this concept patriarchy. India is a patriarchal society, in which means that male is the head of the family. Property is transferred from male members of the society. Another characteristic of society is that society involves some degree of communication and cooperation, which can be described as a culture at a higher level when there is a persistent and generational transmission of knowledge and behavior for learning. How Indian society is evolved? Coming back to evolution of Indian society, India is a country of ancient civilization that goes back to Indus Valley civilization, which flourished during the 3rd millennium BC. In the past, Indian societies were organized around small groups of people, maintaining tribal characteristics. With the passage of time, they were becoming more complex, adopting as many members and establishing new relationships within it. The society exists since man began to populate the planet, though its form of organizations suffered variations throughout history. The society of prehistoric man, as you all know, was organized in hierarchical mode, where a chief, he is the strongest, or the whole sage has the most concentrated power. Now we will discuss how Indian society evolves over a period of time. As you all know that India is a country of ancient civilization that goes back to Indus Valley civilization, which flourished during the 3rd millennium BC. In the past, Indian societies were organized around small groups of people maintaining tribal characteristics. With the passage of time, they were becoming more complex, adopting as many members and establishing new relationships within it. The society exists since man began to populate the planet, though its forms of organization suffered variations throughout history. The society of prehistoric man was organized in a hierarchical mode, where a chief is the most strongest person of the society. He has the whole concentrated power around him. Indian society is composed of diverse cultures, and each one has its own rationale and ideologies that Indians are unique and different from the others. The society in India is quite old and complex in nature. Many scholars have diverse opinions on the origin of Indian society. India is said to be a synthesis of diverse social and cultural elements. It is a synthesis of the Aryan and the Dravidian cultures. The unity between the village, the family, and the legal system was the outcome of this synthesis. The synthesis has created community from the ancient period till today. Continuity from time of Mohenjo-daro, 2500 BC, through Jainism, Buddhism, and Islam, and from the time of the British rule to post-independence India. India's social system is very old and complex one, as we have discussed earlier. The social evolution of Indian subcontinent is rooted since early and middle stone ages. The deep, fathomless Indian history, often traced with the oldest and largest civilization, that is Indus Valley civilization. And hence, we can say that India has a great cultural heritage. It is a mixture. It is rightly called as the melting pot of the civilizations. The archaeological evidence reveals that this was one of the most organized civic life, with developed town planning, a system of writing, having knowledge of copper and gold, standardization of weights and measures, and much other evidence of economic and political institutions are evident in our ancient civilization such as Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. Vedic period is known for development of 4 Vedas, the hymns, the rituals practices, and Vedic mode for pedagogical inspirations. Historically, India has been a place of numerous groups of immigrants from various parts of the world, particularly Europe and Asia, such as Sakas, Parthian, Kushan, Mongol, Portuguese, British, Finch, and Dutch, and others. These groups also carried their cultures to this subcontinent. All these cultural contact in the long run influenced each other, and this has created this subcontinent a place of melting pot of diverse culture. Hence, it is the result of this mixture of various continents that our India has become a unique country. It is rightly called a place of melting pot of diverse culture. This has resulted that India constitute diverse cultures, and followers of all world religions are living together in this country. Its complex social culture and structure and culture is another distinct feature traced through the existence of various races, caste, communities, religion, and languages. Despite such complexity and diversity, it has one identity called unity in diversity. As you all know that India has a melting pot of various culture, we should, as Indians, we should celebrate our rich cultural heritage. We are diverse and we should take proud in this thing. We are not one, we are all one. but different religions, different languages, and this makes us unique and different from all other people all over the world. Unity in diversity. As we have discussed earlier, that India is known as a melting pot of diverse culture, where multiple races, numerous caste and subcaste group, all major religion, sects and cults, distinct communities, different cultural religions and languages coexist, influencing each other, making India a culturally rich and unified nature. As India, we all are one and we should be proud of it, our cultural heritage, not make our country a communal one. We should take pride that we have diverse religions, we are secular, and each religion in our country has a specific place. We are one. The features of diversities are as following. First one is races. B.S. Guha identified all six major racial elements in the Indian population, namely Negrito, Proto-Australoid, Mongoloid, Mediterranean, Western Brachiocephalus and Nordic, in which first three are the oldest inhabitants of the subcontinent. However, the concept pure is no more a social reality due to frequent social mobility. Nowadays, the term ethnic group is widely used. Another feature of diversity is religion. As you all know, that most of the major religions of the world, like Buddhism, Christianity, Hinduism, Islam, Jainism, Jews, Zoroastrian, and many bewildering variety of cults, sects, and other followers live together in Indian society. Communities. Beyond the caste and subcaste groups, there are more than 700 distinct tribal and ethnic communities comprising almost 7.5% of Indian population. They are outside to our caste system and maintain isolation from other cultural groups. However, after independence, the government policy for development has started a process of integration. Now, government of India is trying to integrate the tribal communities into the mainstream population. Language and other cultural diversities. As we are aware that culture is a wider concept. Hence, here we include other remaining factors of diversity. There are diverse languages and diverse cultural religion. According to Grierson, India has 179 languages and 544 dialects. This number will indicate how rich we are. The feature of unity also continued with above mentioned diversity features. Thus, we say that diverse features not always for collide and conflict, but they can coexist together. India is a living example of this. M.N. Srinivas viewed the feature of unity inherent in Hinduism, which represent more than 3/4 of population. The following features of unity also played a significant role in Indian national building. We have one political entity. Politically, almost whole subcontinent was under one kingdom, such as Chandragupta Maurya, Gupta period in ancient India. Since Mughal period and British period clearly marked as one of the political regime. Therefore, Indian subcontinent from ancient period to modern period is more or less has politically unite, except for few aberrations. Then there is a territorial integrity of Indian subcontinent. Geographically, whole subcontinent has one identity, separated by Himalayas and the Indian seas. Though it varies within as Northern Himalayas, Aravali range, Peninsular India, and united by mighty river system, which encompasses entire subcontinent. Hence, our geographical features also make us one. Now, there is a common culture. Common cultural initiatives reflected throughout the Indian history. The Emperor Ashoka worked for the unity of India by achieving cultural and religious harmony with non-violent principles. Mughal Emperor Akbar projected the concept of religion Deen-e-Ilahi. Also, he called it as a synthesis of Hinduism and Islam. Then, therefore, on one side, we have diversity in terms of race, caste, religion, culture, and communities. While on other side, we find unifying features like one political entity, territorial integrity of subcontinent, existence of all the major religions, but tied within one thread, single Varna model and Varna Ashram system encompassing whole India. Secondly, the goal of education is to perpetuate and cement the difference among various social milieus. Through the complementarity of homogeneity and heterogeneity, education plays a significant role in nation building, which Durkheim called as organic solidarity. So, education can be used as one of the tool for maintaining India as a one. As you all know that India has a one national core curriculum. Education in India comes under the concurrent list. That is, it means that in education, we have control of central control and state control also. So, we are strict to one united India. A.R. Desai, in his book, Social Background of Indian Nationalism, also explain the emergence and evolution of Indian nationalism during independence movement. During freedom struggle, above mentioned different identities considered as a hurdle. However, they are joined together under one umbrella called Indian National Congress. Different identities coexisted, but also fought for one nation. To sum up, we can say that we have discussed about Indian society, how it has evolved in the deep-rooted history of evolution of Indian society not only depicts the major events, but also its unique character of unity and diversity and continuity as one Indian culture. Culture is very significant to understand any society and its education system. As Indians, we should be proud of our rich cultural society and preserve it at all costs. Thank you.